Hello everyone. In today's video lecture, we are going to see the what are recurrent neural networks in detail. What is its working mechanism and what are its different applications? So, do you know how Google's autocomplete feature predicts the rest of the words the user is trying to type on the Google search engine? So working mechanism behind this is there is a past historical records, there is a huge collection of the large volumes of the most frequently occurring consecutive words, and on the basis of those historical data sets which are available, Google search engine tries to predict what will be the next word. So that is the autocomplete feature, how it predicts the next word. So this particular collection of large volumes of the data set, it is fed to the recurrent neural network. We are going to see what is this recurrent neural network in detail. It analyzes the data by finding the sequence of the words which are there sequentially occurring frequently, what are the most frequently occurring words, and it tries to build a model. It tries to build a model. This model is nothing but a set of the algorithms which are working in the background on the Google search engine to predict the next word in the sentence. Now, for example, if I am trying to search on the Google search engine, what is the best food to eat in the last? So, of course, the next answer will be autocomplete feature that it is going to predict is Vegas. Now, we often see all these things are happening when we are trying to type in something on the Google search engine, but we don't put much emphasis on it, how the Google is thinking about it, how come, is it a magic or something like that, but we don't put much emphasis on it, what is happening on the background. So it auto-completes the search this way based on the whatever past or historical records or the data set which are available. We will see how it works, what is the working mechanism of the recurrent neural networks in detail. So what is a neural network? Neural networks which are used in the deep learning. Okay, deep learning, which consists of n number of hidden layers which processes the complex algorithm, which processes the huge data set with the help of complex algorithms. So it consists of the different layers. It consists of different layers. So for example, this is input layer, these are hidden layers, and this is nothing but an output layer. So it consists of the different layers which are connected to each other, and it works on the structure and the functions of the human brain. So how human brain works, what is the mechanism of the human brain, how brain decides to take certain action based on the certain event. So for example, there are the different sensory organs, and if one sensory organ sends a particular signal to the brain will be decide to take certain action, and then it will be reflected back. Okay, so of course the sensory part of the body, whichever has got the activation, so in the last video lecture I had given you the example of the mosquito bite on our body. So only that particular part of the body, the neurons under that, whichever are perceptrons which are related to that particular sensory part of the body will get activated, and the higher amount of the weightage will be associated to that particular neuron. So it works on the similarly it has got a functionality similar to the human brain working mechanism. It learns from the huge volumes of the data set. It uses the complex algorithms to train the neural network. So for example, here I have got the two different breeds of the dogs. So these are the images, these are nothing but the input images of the two different breeds of the dogs. So it is fed to the input layer. Now these are the images, so features are extracted out of it. Of course, definitely these are the dogs only, but there are certain characteristic feature which differentiates these two dogs, okay, which differentiates these two dogs from each other, dog breeds from each other. So these are the input, and then there are certain weights which are associated, W0, W1, W2, W3 for these input signals, X1, X2, X3. depending on its characteristic feature of the dog, the weights are associated, and these are passed on, and then there will be the output layer. So this output layer will be classifying this input sets of images into German Shepherd or Labrador dog. So it identifies the dog's breed. Now, what is the neural network? Neural network, it is used in deep learning. It consists of the n number of different layers or hidden layers which are connected to each other. It works on the structure and the functions which are similar to the human brain. It learns from the huge volumes of the data. It uses the complex algorithms in the background to train the neural network. Now, these are the networks. Some of these networks do not require memorizing the past output. Okay, they do not require to memorize the past output. Why? Because this, let's say I am, this is a particular neuron. This layer's input is nothing but the output from this particular hidden layer. Okay, this neuron's input is nothing but the output which has been generated from this hidden layer. Okay, based on the hidden layer's output, this is nothing but acting as an input to this particular layer. So whatever data which has been processed, the data intermediate data which has been processed, that intermediate data's output is acting as an input to the next hidden layer. So this is input layer, hidden layers and output layers, and then on that basis we can classify what is the dog's breed. Now, feed forward neural network, this is one type of the neural network where, as the name suggests, it is feed forward. Feed forward means we are just simply passing on the data from one layer to another layer. Simply passing on the data, there is no recursive or recurrent, or there is no looking back. Okay, if we want to change something, we want to adjust some weights, we want to adjust some kind of input or characteristic feature, or we want to make, let's say in the previous layer, the input weight which was associated with a particular characteristic feature is 4 and we want to reduce it to 0, we don't want to give any importance to that particular characteristic feature, there is no looking back or there is no loop back. Okay, so this is simply, as the name suggests, it is a feed forward neural network. So it is, there are the input layers, hidden layers, and then there are the output layers, just data is passed on from one layer to another layer. So there is a now this X is input, it is fed to the activation function, and then the output is generated. That's it. So input layer, hidden layer, output layer, and predicted output is predicted. So decisions are based on the current input, whatever current inputs are there. No memory about the past here, that we are not storing any memory about the past, and no future scope also. So that is a drawback of feed forward neural network. So why, so there is, now there comes why we need a recurrent neural network. So these were the issues in feed forward neural network. It cannot handle the sequential data if suddenly some data changes, but since it has already propagated that particular data, we cannot change, or we don't have the incremental kind of iteratively, we cannot change anything. It considers only the current input. It cannot memorize the previous inputs. So that is the problem with the feed forward neural network. So then there is a need for the recurrent neural network which has come up. So it is, recurrent neural network is nothing but the solution to the feed forward neural network. So what are the advantages of recurrent neural networks? It can handle the sequential data. It considers the current input and also the previously received inputs. And it can memorize the previous inputs due to its internal memory. There is some internal memory which is associated with it. It will memorize that particular previous input. So now here is the input signal X, which is fed to the activation function. It is fed to the hidden layer. And then there is a looping. Okay. There is a looping. We can adjust the weights. We can do some adjustments. We can change something, or we can, if we want to assign or penalize, or we want to reward some particular characteristic feature neuron that is contributing much in the learning process, then we can go ahead with that. So that is the advantage of the recurrent neural network. So this is the output which is based on the input. So F, and then there can be multiple inputs as well, x1, x2, x3, x4. So that is nothing but a solution to the feed forward neural network. Now, what is a recurrent neural network? There is an input layer, number of hidden layers, there are output layers, and then this is in compact, we can show it like this. So input, from this input the output is generated, and the there is a recurrent. Why the name is recurrent? Because there is a looping over here, and recurrent neural network works on the principle of the saving the output of the layer, saving the output of the previous layer, and feeding this back. You can feed this back to the input in order to predict the output of the layer. So you can do certain adjustments, or looping mechanism is there in this recurrent neural network. So this is how recurrent neural network works. Now let's say YT-1 stands for the previous layer's output. Previous layer's input is XT-1, and then there are certain characteristic features. There are certain key, C is nothing but certain parameters, input parameters. Okay, so let's see this functionality first. So this h of t, what is h of t? That is a new state. H of t is a new state. And then there is fc ht-1, xt. Fc is nothing but a function with the parameter c. ht-1 is the old state, ht-1, old hidden state. And then there is an input vector at timestamp t. Okay, so whatever hidden layers, previous hidden layers output is acting as an input to the next hidden layer. Previous hidden layers output is acting as an input to the next hidden layer. Okay, so this way the recurrent neural network works. So this layer's input is nothing but the previous hidden layer's output. So there are the different types of RNNs. What are the different types of RNNs? There is a single input, single output, one to one, and it is used for the regular machine learning problems, and this is called as vanilla neural network. Then there is a single input and multiple outputs. Now this one to many network generates sequence of outputs, for example image captioning. What do you mean by this? Let's say there is only one particular image is given, but there are multiple objects which are there, and we are just trying to caption all those objects. we are trying to caption all those objects. So that is nothing but a one to many recurrent neural network. So example is image captioning. So if one image is there, there are n number of objects, we will try to caption all the objects. Then there are the types of the recurrent neural network, many to one. So there are, let's say, multiple inputs are there and single output is there. Now for example, multiple inputs and single output is nothing but a many to one kind of a recurrent neural network. The example is sentiment analysis. Now where this sentiment analysis is used, let's say I am trying to predict the quality of a certain product based on the product reviews which have been written on Amazon website. Now there are, let's say, 400-500 reviews of that particular product has been written, and out of 499 reviews, let's say 300 reviews are talking about the positive. Okay, 100 reviews, they are they say that the product is really good, but it is not satisfied my needs, something like that. So but still it is in the positive category. Okay, but and there are certain reviews, like 99 reviews which says that the product was broken after usage, after 6 months of usage, so that kind of thing, but the product is good. So overall rating from this, overall sentiments out of this is going to be positive reviews of that particular product. Positive reviews of that particular product. So this is nothing but a many to one. So many to one network takes in a sequence of inputs. Sentiment analysis, whereas the given sentence can be classified as expressing a positive or negative sentiments. So these are also kind of a recurrent neural network, where we have multiple inputs, n number of reviews of a particular product on the Amazon, and we are getting one single output, whether it is a positive review or a negative review, and on that basis we will be deciding whether to buy that particular product or not. Then another one is the multiple inputs and multiple output. This is a kind of there are multiple inputs, x1, x2, x3. So these inputs are fed to the activation function, and then we will be getting multiple outputs, y1, y2, y3. So it is similar to this, x1, x2, x3, which is fed to the activation function. Activation function, I have prepared one video. And then there are multiple outputs which are generated, y1, y2, y3, yn. So many to many networks takes in a sequence of inputs, generates a sequence of outputs. So example of this is nothing but a machine translation. Machine translation, we are giving certain kind of a machine translation. We are trying to translate or kind of a speech recognition or something like that. We are talking here n number of sentence, and from this n number of sentence we are trying to generate multiple outputs. Okay, so what are the this is the last slide. What are the applications of recurrent neural network? Time series analysis, time series prediction, which is normally used in stock market prediction. Why it is called as a time series prediction? So let's say from the first five values I am trying to predict the sixth value. From the first, let's say 1 to 1000 records, I am trying to predict 1001 value of a particular stock. So that's why it is called as a time series. Time series, why? Because it is based on the time stamps. Then image captioning, we have discussed this. Now there is only one image, one to many. This is a kind of a recurrent neural network. What it is? It is one to many. Why one to many? Because only one image is given, and we are trying to caption for the multiple objects in that. Let's say for this there is a dog, there is a ball, there is a sky, there are trees, there is a ground. Then sentiment analysis, we have already discussed this. That is a kind of a Amazon product reviews. If you want to do the sentiment analysis for the Amazon products, the reviews, like positive review, negative review or neutral. So that we can do using natural language processing. Then there is a speech recognition. Suppose if you are traveling to a country like China or some other country, and if you are very good at English but you don't know that Chinese language, so you can talk on the phone that in English, and it will be converting for you it in Chinese language or any other Spanish language. So that is nothing but a speech recognition. So this is many to many. We will stop over here. In the next lecture, we will see what are the vanishing gradient problem and exploding gradient problem. Thank you.